Welcome back to That Morning Show. Now, everyone, please put your hands together and welcome Laura VanderVoort, from the star of the new ABC series, V. Sorry, I got so excited.
Okay, thank you.
We've been waiting for you all morning. I got excited. Congratulations.
I feel the same way. Thank you.
So tonight is the big premiere.
It is, yeah.
That's got to be exciting. Do you have any plans to watch it with family and friends?
I think it's just going to be a quiet little viewing in my little apartment with my boyfriend. We all viewed it, actually, before I left Vancouver at Elizabeth Mitchell's apartment.
Oh, no
So
way.
The cast got together, and we sat on the floor, had pop, and watched it
beforehand. That had to be kind of fun.
Yeah, it was. It was great.
So now you'll show it to your boyfriend tonight, and this will be the first time he's going to see it?
Yes, he's seen pieces of it, but this is the first time he's going to see the entire pilot.
Oh, that's exciting. You're going to be watching his every expression.
I'm going to judge him on everything that he does.
Yeah, he better laugh at the right places. He better be very intently looking at the right places. I know how that goes.
Yes.
All right, so now many people actually remember the original V series from the 80s, but for those of us who don't, tell us about the show.
It was the original miniseries in 1984. It's based on a sci-fi storyline where it's visitors that come to Earth, and they appear to be here for good, and they just want to borrow our water and our power, but it turns out that they aren't here for good, and they are slowly going to take over, and ours is kind of a revamped version. We're not redoing it, but we're trying to carry on in its
memory. Some of the same characteristics from the show from the 80s, but with a little new twist on it.
Yeah, it's post 9/11. It's the world we live in now, dealing with those issues.
Okay. Probably a lot of fodder there for you guys to play with.
Yes, definitely.
Now tell character Lisa. She's actually one of the visitors, right?
Lisa is a peace ambassador. She is a visitor. And her task is to recruit humans, really the younger humans, as she wants to be part of the Peace Ambassador program. But slowly after the pilot, the audience is going to realize she's actually there for other purposes, and she is at a higher rank than they originally realized.
So is she bad then?
That I can't tell you, and honestly can't, because the producers are kind of being tight-lipped about it.
So we're there in suspense and try to decide which side she's on?
Exactly, and I don't even know, so I'm playing it as honest as I possibly can, which is best for the audience, and then that way we're both surprised because, you know, Lisa could be there for good.
You never know. Every script, it's going to be a different outcome probably, right?
Yep.
All right, well, we actually have a clip from tonight's episode of V, so let's take a look.
Having a good time?
Having a great time.
Have you heard about our new Peace Ambassador program?
Peace Ambassador program.
You sign up, hang out with V's, learn about our culture, and you act as V ambassadors in your own communities. You even get a uniform.
Oh, it says you have to be 18 years old to join. I'm only 17.
You can still join, you just need your parents' signature.
Yeah, well, that's kind of a tough sell right now. My parents don't even know we're here.
It's too bad. I just got assigned to the New York chapter. Gotta spend some time together.
I gotta say, I hope all visitors and aliens look like you.
That's actually, we choose our bodies, so she kind of chose it based on what her task was, which is
to lure people in, because you did. Yeah. You would have gotten me with that whole bid.
Hey.
I know, but if you turn out to be evil, I'm gonna be kind of scared.
Well, hopefully I don't. But,
exactly, I'm pulling for you. All right, so let's talk a little bit about the cast on the show. Huge cast, Scott Wolf, Elizabeth Mitchell, and Morris Chestnut, who I've met. He seems like a doll.
Yeah, the cast, and I'm not just saying this, we are so lucky with the cast that we have. They are all sweet, they're all down to earth. We've got Elizabeth from Lost, Scott Wolf from Party of Five, and I mean, I was starstruck with Scott Wolf because I grew up watching him.
Yeah,
I named my dog after
Bailey. No, you didn't. Did you tell him that?
I did. When I first met him, I was very nervous, and I'm like, I named my dog after you. He didn't quite know what to say.
He was like, thanks.
Yeah. Yeah.
How cute. That was a really cute moment. You guys are going to laugh about that later on, huh?
Hopefully.
We'll find out. Oh, don't worry. I do that on a daily basis here.
Okay.
Yeah, really embarrassing things. All right, so most people actually know you from your role as Supergirl Kara Kent on Smallville. Mm-hmm. You have a bit of a following yourself. Are you a big sci-fi fan?
I am, yeah. I mean, it really started when I got on Smallville. And it's just the fact that I love sci-fi is that it gives strong female roles. A lot of the times in television you don't get that, but on sci-fi they allow the women to be strong and independent and supers, and that's kind of where I fell into loving sci-fi and the fact that really anything is possible. And then V allowed me to play the same strong female role.
Yeah, as an actress that must be a lot of fun.
It is. Yeah.
You also have another sci-fi oriented project coming out. Tell us about Riverworld.
Riverworld is based on a novel by Joseph Farmer. And it's also a miniseries, and it's kind of about a purgatory world where people die all over, all walks of life, different periods of their lives, all end up in the same spot, which is along like an endless bank. And it's where they all just kind of come together and they try to figure out what they did wrong in their lives, try to meet up with those that they've loved and lost. It's a very
interesting... Is it emotional? It sounds emotional.
Yeah. It starts off with Tom O'Pennicott and I. He's from Dollhouse, so another kind of sci-fi-esque.
Yeah.
And we're fiancés, and you know, something at the beginning happens, and we die, and it's us trying to find one another again.
Oh,
yeah,
sad.
It's a heartwarming story.
Sounds good, though. Okay, yeah. The thing that I find the most intriguing about you, as you sit here all perfect and dolled up, is that you are a black belt in karate.
I am.
Really, woman?
Yeah, second degree black belt, and I started when I was about 13, and when I was 19, I had my second degree black belt. I mean, I grew up as a tomboy. My dad wanted a son, so I kind of had to.
He was like, karate or else.
Yeah, or no gymnastics, no ballet, just martial arts. So, I mean, that's helped me with my career, especially with Supergirl.
And the strong woman roles that you're playing, of course.
Yeah, so the thing I grew up doing.
So you're not faking it.
No.
No, you know what you're doing. All right, so I know it's probably going to be no competition at all, but how quickly do you think you could take Mark Long down?
Pretty quickly.
Do you? Would it just take a one move?
You wanna
spar a little bit,
no.
Mark Long? You think
I'm
you can
eighth
handle
degree.
It?
I'm eighth degree.
Mark,
black
don't
belt.
Be scared.
You're eighth degree.
Mark,
right.
I don't see you coming over here. I feel like you're a little
are
nervous.
Are you challenging?
Are you nervous?
I'll let you guys finish up.
Oh, Mark.
Finish up.
I don't want to, you know, pretty up.
I know.
Rest up the pretty.
I am.
No.
Look.
And I think you shouldn't. You know, we don't want to embarrass Mark Long.
No. I can tell your technique is amazing just from that.
Seen this one before?
Yeah. Karate Kid?
Yeah. It's Machio. Call that one a Machio.
Nice, Mark. I don't think Laura's impressed. All right, thank you so much for stopping by, Laura. Congratulations. Tonight's a big night.
Thank you. Yes, please watch.
They all will. Everyone, be sure to catch Laura and V premiering tonight on ABC. Now over to Mark, who's used to being beaten up by girls.
You know what's ironic? I'm actually naming my next dog Vandervoort. See how that ties in? It's weird like that. Coming up, we're going to meet the Emmy Award-winning costume designer behind American Idol, and So You Think You Can Dance, Dance, Dance. Stick around, TMS. We'll be right back.